From the windy city of Chicago, baseball from beautiful Wrigley Field. This evening, we've got a matchup from the AL Central Division between the Minnesota Twins and the Cleveland Indians. Indians
and
baseball
now. 2021 Cleveland Indians.
That'll bring up Luis Arraez, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Set to deal on 2-2. Softly hit toward the hole, reined in, and there's one gone to start the night. And now in the box, Byron Buxton, lifetime in this matchup. He comes in hitting right at a 300 clip. He also has one home run. Swing and a miss. Looked like the knuckle curve there, and that's out number two. Digging in next, Jorge Polanco, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
Yeah, this is his power side, Matt. He definitely quite a bit more pop in his bat swinging left-handed.
Bradley shading to his right. And he makes the catch to retire the side. Now to the plate, Miles Straw. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 3-1 pitch. Takes a strike for a full count now, 3-2.
Yeah, this is one of my biggest pet peeves in the game. When guys get count leverage and take fastballs, it's a game of fastballs. You calibrate everything off the heater. Surprising take right there.
Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single. Here's a look over first, and the runner will get back standing. Straw gets his lead at first, nobody out. Into the box, Amed Rosario. Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. He's running. This one's flared toward left center. Simmons onto the grass, but he won't get there. It falls in, and the throw will go to second as they get the force out. Next up is Jose Ramirez.
The third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
Hey, I know it's early and we're in the first right here, but he's going to have to work that heater to both sides of the plate. He cannot get away with missing over the heart of the plate all night.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. He'll try again, 1-2. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. Runner at first with two gone. And digging in now, Franmil Reyes. One-two. Gets him looking up around the letters. The number four Minnesota hitter, Josh Donaldson. Lifetime versus this arm. He's gone 3-for-8. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Swing and a flare down the line. And that's in there. Base hit. At the plate, Max Kepler. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. At the knees for a called strike, and it's back to even at 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. On to first, and they get them both. So bases empty now after the double play. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Miguel Sano. In the air out to right. Zimmer's in pursuit. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Last half of the second set to go, and here comes the first baseman, Bobby Bradley. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Sliced hard on the ground, but that finds its way through for a base hit. He's around first, heading for two. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Batting fifth, the left fielder, Carlos Ramirez.
So now to the plate, Harold Ramirez. Count is 1-2 now. That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Kepler moves to his right and puts this one away in the alley for out number one. The runner on second with one down now. And up next, the San Diego area native, Bradley Zimmer. Now the 2-1. Now a bunt attempt here. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Swing and a liner. And that's through into left, a base hit. Throw comes in to third now, so they're at the corners here with only one out.
Batting it, the catcher, Lopez Torres.
And now, Roberto Perez. Boy, he just threw that fastball by him. With two strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout, or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Good time to try to put the ball down in the strike zone. You can either get a strikeout or a potential double play ball.
Now another 2-2. And another foul ball. Runners are at the corners with one man out. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Another payoff pitch. Johnny finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat.
Batting none.
2-1, two out, and that'll bring Andrés Giménez in to bat. The set and the 1-1. Hit on the ground out to short. Simmons has it, and the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Now it'll be Nick Gordon as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Stepping up is Mitch Garver. His prior history versus this arm. He's got two hits in 16 tries. And on 10 occasions, he's been a strikeout victim. And right into the shift. Ramirez is there. And that's the second out. Now with the plate is Andrelton Simmons.
Andrelton
Simmons. The 1-2 is taken, but called strike three as he might have gotten a little extra off the plate that time. Bottom of the third now, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Miles Straw. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
The batter, number one, shortstop,
Stepping in now, Ahmed Rosario, Indian shortstop behind 1-2 in the count. Line drive, base hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now. Into the box now, Jose Ramirez. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul.
He's got a good feel for his off-speed pitches second time through the order, and we just saw three in a row.
Swung on and chopped up the middle to second for one. On to first, and they get the double play. So a man at third here with two gone.
And here's Franmil Reyes stepping in.
Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. And this throw gets away from him.
The first baseman, Bobby.
Standing in now, Bobby Bradley. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. And it's fouled away. In the dirt, and now let's see. And he is in there. They couldn't get him at second. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four. Up next, Harold Ramirez. 0-1 here in the early going. The 1-1. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Kepler will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Now back to the leadoff spot in the Twins lineup. Stepping in, Luis Arraez. He's 0-1 thus far. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch. High in the air out towards shallow right. Waiting on it is Zimmer. He's got it, one away. So one down, no one aboard, and that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone. Buxton ahead in the count, three balls and a strike.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Okay. Three balls and two strikes to the Twins center fielder.
With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set.
Oh, look at the diving stop. He gathers the throw. It's there, and he's out.
Up next for Minnesota, the second baseman, Jorge Polanco.
At the plate now is Jorge Polanco. He popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
It's been more than two innings since this guy's allowed anyone to reach base. He looks pretty unbeatable on the bump right now.
Counts even, 2-2 for Polanco. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. And now here is Bradley Zimmer. He singled in his first AB. And he got him.
Now in the box, Roberto Perez. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
And that'll find its way into center field for a one-out hit.
Now back, second baseman. Oh, good.
To the plate now, Andrés Giménez. Still 2-2. Full count now, 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Lifted the other way down the left field line. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one out double.
The batter, number 7.
At the plate now, Miles Straw. Here's a looping fly ball out to right. Polanco backs up and takes care of it. Two away. So two on with two away. And up next will be the shortstop, Amed Rosario. Payoff pitch on its way. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Sano is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. Josh Donaldson digging in now. He collected a base hit his first time up.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth. Now one down with the bases empty. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Max Kepler. The 1-1 home. Is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth. Here's Miguel Sano, flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far.
Almost, Matty, almost went deep his last AB, certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something.
But we'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Ralph Garza is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, Jose Ramirez. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And this is strike three called, says Clyde Washington. Might have looked a bit low, but that's out number one.
A designated hitter, Rugby.
Now the 1-1 pitch. One run, eight hits, no errors to this point for the Indians. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going.
He's going to be thinking about that pitch all night if he doesn't have a big game right here. Pulled his front shoulder and everything went with it.
High chopper to third. Fielded cleanly. And there are two away now. Now to bat, Bobby Bradley. It was a walk in his last trip. Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll bring forth the rookie outfielder, Nick Gordon. The 2-1. Hit softly on the ground to first. Scooped up, And he'll step on first himself for the out.
So here is Mitch Garver, 0 for 1 for him here in this one.
Now a curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three ball count.
Now the 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed. He got him. In now is Andrelton Simmons. 0 for 1, went down looking his first time up. No runs, just one hit, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in the outfielder, Harold Ramirez. The 1-1 home.
Nope.
Oh, not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Ramirez on the first, nobody out. And he leaves off the breaking ball there as he moves ahead to 2-1.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
The 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. Two-two, one more time. It's looked at, and the count moves full.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Oh, they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Next up, Roberto Perez. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. 1-1 is going to be a sacrifice attempt as he gets it down. Only play to the pitcher covering, and the runner moves into second on the play. So a runner at second, two down now. That'll bring Andrés Giménez into bat. Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike. And a swing and a miss as he pulled the string on the breaking ball, and the inning is over. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in Luis Arraez, 0-for-2 on his line thus far.
Know you're only down one right here, but the exploding stuff that's coming out of the back end of a lot of teams' bullpens. I mean, just north of 95 plus, stuff diving all over the plate. It's gotten a lot tougher to scratch across runs against these teams' bullpens.
Count even at 2-2. Grounded softly to the right, reined in. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. One gone now in the Minnesota 7th, and that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. 1-1. Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame. Digging in, the switch hitter, Jorge Polanco. No hits to this point. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Boy, he's been great in this one. He's only one strike away from putting another zero on the scoreboard.
And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Last half of the 7th here, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Miles Straw. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch.
Three ball.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Hit on the ground toward the left. And there's a base hit, so a chance for some insurance here to start out the home half of the 7th.
The batter, number 1. Lift up. Amen.
Into the box, Amed Rosario. And a bunt attempt misses, so he's behind now 1-2. Swing and a miss there as the breaking ball takes care of him for the first out. Next, it'll be Jose Ramirez. Not providing much out of the three hold in this one. Hitless in 3 at bats so far. The 1-1 home. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball 2. Oscar Mercado will come on now and run at first base following the injury. Mercado stands at first with 1 out. Hit back up the middle. The second for 1 on to first, but not in time as he beats it out. So it's a runner at first with 2 men out, and digging in now, Franmil Reyes. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Now the 2-1 pitch. And a great location that time on the corner. 3-2 now.
3-2, 2 out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Well hit the other way again. It's into the gap. It's in at second safely. As also on the play, a run comes across to score.
The first baseman, Bobby.
At the plate, Bobby Bradley. Into the corner and slicing foul.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Dribbled down the third baseline. Now another 1-2. Hit hard on the ground is short. And that's through into left, a base hit. And they're going to hold that runner at third base, as even with 2 away, they didn't like their chances there. Jorge Alcala takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this 7th inning. Into the box now, Harold Ramirez. Lined into right field, and it's going to get down, a base hit. In to score easily is the runner from third, and the lead will swell to 3 now in the 7th inning. In now, Bradley Zimmer. Yanked hard but foul to the right.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
Grounded back up the middle. Step on second for the force, and that'll do it. Veteran DH Josh Donaldson. Called strike, and he's behind 1-2. Swing. swung on and he went fishing in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Donaldson is retired and there's one away. Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. He's hitless in his two at bats so far. 3-2 pitch. And he fouls this one off. Looking to punch him out again. The pitch. He can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat. So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four.
Up next to the plate.
Next, here is Nick Gordon. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. 1-1 home. It is offered at and missed.
One ball.
He chased it for strike two.
I mean, this offense has struggled because they haven't been able to make the adjustment. He stayed staunch on the outer half, and these guys have not worked the ball the other way.
And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Digging in will be Roberto Perez, and he'll start out the bottom of the eighth inning. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this will land untouched. The next 3-2. Hit in the air to center field. Center fielder giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. Andres Jimenez the next to bat. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Fouled off. The 2-2.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
He's got it, and there's out number two. Oscar Mercado digging in now. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Bouncer up the middle. And the off-balance throw will be too late, so a good effort that time, but it's an infield single. To the plate now, Ahmed Rosario fouled away. Payoff pitch on its way. Breezes him, a strikeout looking. Stepping in once again is Mitch Garver. No hits for him to this point, not unlike many of his fellow teammates. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
Oh, and he goes the other way, and he drives it out to deep right center field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And the Twins have something brewing right away. It's a leadoff double. Standing in now, Andrelton Simmons. Two balls and a strike to count to Andrelton Simmons. To 2-2 now.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
As a look, now the pitch.
Three balls.
Luis Arraez who represents the potential tying run here, waits on deck. Now the 3-2 pitch into center field, and that's going to get down for a base hit. And they'll get it in quickly. It's first and third now with nobody out. Emmanuel Classe takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door. Into the box, Luis Arraez. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
And the runner from third crosses the plate. Stepping in now, Byron Buxton. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2. Here's a swing and a ball hit into the air to left center and shallow. Rosario backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out. Next to hit is Jorge Polanco. 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Now the payoff pitch home is in there. A called strike three. Striding forward now is the DH, Josh Donaldson. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Set and the 2-1 pitch. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed. And now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening.
Now this guy's got some of the nastiest stuff in the game. And it is absolutely no fun for an offense to try and piece together any type of attack when he's throwing this stuff.
Final strike for the Twins. Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Twins DH. Max Kepler would be next. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. A swing and a high drive to right center field. And this is going to wind up as extra bases, as that'll play one for sure and maybe a second. And the second run will score as that evens things at 3.
Now back to right fielder.
At the plate, Max Kepler. Had nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1.
Man, that's a great take right there. Backdoor slider, just missed the outside corner. This guy must have a really good eye. Most guys swing at that pitch.
3-1 to him now. 3-1, here it is. And that misses ball 4, so it's first and second now with 2 out. So the next to bat will be Miguel Sano, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Here's the 1-1. Donaldson at second, Kepler at first, 2 out in the inning. Here's a line drive, and this game may not stay tied for long. That's down for extra bases. And a huge insurance run is across to score all the way from first. Now a 5-3 game. Blake Parker takes over now with 2 gone here in the top of inning number 9. At the plate now, Nick Gordon. This one's down to third. Throw on to first will finally retire him as the inning will draw to a close. Alex Colomay comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 48.
Alex. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And next, the dangerous power threat, Jose Ramirez. Now the 1-1 pitch is taken for ball 2. Late that time for a strike. Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, and that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
Next for the Indians is the designated hitter, Fran Moraes. He's doubled and singled in 4 at-bats in this contest. 1-1. Is swung on and missed one for ball. Strike number two. And that misses 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two. Next to stand in is Bobby Bradley. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Good swing, but a late one as it's fouled off to the left. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Yeah, and that's just a punch to the gut of the home fans as they watch their team fall behind at the top of the ninth. Then they can't get it done at the bottom and come away with a loss.
And this evening's contest comes to a close, 5-3 the final. The Minnesota Twins came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Jorge Alcala is the winning pitcher of record. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious Twins, 5 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left.